The Circle by Elizabeth Baines. With Sherrie Hewson, John McArdle, Jane Hazelgrove, and Jonathon Morris. Episode 1, Squaring the Circle.
You know, we didn't have a lot in common with anyone in the circle. Well, apart from that thing that brought us all together. The problem of juggling work and kids. My husband, Geoff, and I were run off our feet with our chain of social clubs cum snooker centres.
Geoff, you're looking after the kids at 5.
Oh, Jenny, I fixed a meeting with the new manager.
Oh, Geoff!
Well, like I told you, we're looking into the possibility of extending the golden pocket.
Oh, yes, well, that's great, Geoff. You're lining our blooming pockets and turning them to gold. But what about the kids? Oh, I suppose you've forgotten I'm interviewing the receptionist for the purple coconut.
Oh, damn, yes.
Oh, I'm not asking my mum again. She'd had enough childcare in her time. She needs a life of her own. Oh, well, one of us will have to take them with us again.
Oh, Mum, do we have to go to the club again? It's boring.
Yeah, Mum, it is.
Trish Abbas, next door, was going up the wall as well.
We've had a dinner invitation. This professor at the hospital. Tarek's doing some research with him on the metabolic unit. Next Wednesday. And I haven't found a city yet.
Like me and Geoff, the Abbases had not long moved onto the estate, built where the old clothing factory used to be. Described in the brochure as an exclusive development in the city village suburb of Whittleshulme. Ideal for business people, which is what most of them were. Off into Manchester every morning with a briefcase and a Mercedes. And discerning families. Which I suppose meant us and the Abbases.
Oh, Crystal, don't throw things near that French window! This is it. One or two young families and all the rest yuppies. Well, of course, they are expensive. Tarek wasn't at all sure at first. I mean, even on a doctor's salary. But they're worth it, aren't they?
It seemed like Trish Abbas had achieved her great dream in life.
Oh, so quiet, isn't it, with the walls and the gate on the main road? I'm very happy with the en-suites upstairs.
There was just one problem.
Not a babysitting teenager in sight.
Geoff, can you take Emma and Hayley to Bally this afternoon?
Oh, yeah, Dad.
Yeah, Daddy.
What, me?
Yes, you.
Jenny, I set up a meeting with this air care fella, the sponsorship deal.
Oh, great.
Oh, Dad.
Damn, it's really important, this. He's about to snap the bait. I'm telling you, our players in his air gel. Greased lightning they'll be under them tournament lights. Well, I'm promising him a launch of his product the night we open pocket shakers.
Oh, well, so long as we're shaking the pounds out of the punters' pockets. Meanwhile, the ballet goes up the spout.
Oh, we don't want to miss the ballet.
No, don't you worry, Emma. It's okay, Jenny. I'll take him to ballet.
Oh, Daddy.
Hooray!
I'll give him a ring and I'll hold him off for an hour. Let him think I'm buttering up another hustler. Investigating a range of sponsorship possibilities. Get him itching to settle the deal. No, Jenny, I'm not having them girls missing their ballet.
Oh, come here, Emma. Leave your dad alone. Let me do your hair. Hayley, run up and get them ballet things.
OK.
No, Jenny, what am I working for if my two little girls can't live like princesses and do what they want?
Oh, yes. It wasn't that Geoff didn't care about the matter of the kids. He was a proud father.
Everything I do, Jenny, I do for them kids.
Yeah, I know.
It was just that he had this little blind spot when it came to the practicalities of childcare.
Ow! Ow!
No, I know people wouldn't think it. How much them kids figure in everything I do. They look at me businesses. Snooker, social clubs, they think it's just a man's world.
Oh, they don't notice the women working behind the bars and doing the wages and the accounts.
Oh, now, Jenny, my love, you know how much I appreciate what you do. I couldn't have done it without you.
True, we sit still, Emma.
Oh!
No, what I'm saying, people look. They think of the shady side, which I'll grant it's had in the past. Well, I didn't get me face scar for nothing, did I?
No, you didn't.
People wouldn't think it has out to do with the kids.
Oh, no. The amount we have to take them kids with us to hang about at the clubs.
Oh, Mum, Paul!
Well, yeah, this is what I'm saying. This is the kind of change I've been making. We've got our kids' room at the Golden Pocket.
Oh, Dad, I'm fed up with the kids' room. It's for little kids. It's boring.
And every deal I do, it's the kids that's foremost in my mind. What I can provide for them. This new house, the private school, all the activities, the ballet, the riding out at Wilmslow. I've always vowed they'd want for nothing. You know that. All the paraphernalia, the riding whips.
Crops, Daddy.
Them fancy sticking out net things.
Tutus, Daddy.
See, they've got a different language. They're going beyond me up into higher levels of society. Stopovers with that ambassador's daughter. Out to a blooming castle for a birthday tea with that maggot farmer's
kid.
Yeah,
and they'll need driving out to that and all.
Yeah, Dad, we will.
Well, yeah. Yeah, of course. I'm not having them miss out on the opportunities I've worked me guts out to set up for them.
Well, I'll be finished in time to collect them from Bally, but I've still got to take them to the Purple Coconut after.
Oh, Mum, no.
Oh, I'll have to get me Mum to pick them up at 9 again. We're going to have to stop taking advantage of her like this.
Yeah, well, Jenny, once we've got this opening over, we'll have more time for that sort of thing.
Honestly, Jenny, it's not as though we need a sitter very often. We hardly ever get out. If Tarek's not down, that hospital is fast asleep on the couch. We have to turn down half the invitations we get, but dinner at this professor's, it's important to his career. We can't not go. Oh, you just don't get French windows like these, do you, in new houses? Mind you know, Jenny, the paint in our lounge is knocking already.
Looked like Trisha's great dream was turning out to have its little flaws.
I said to Tarek, I wish we could have it done. But like he says, we've had all this expense. It's not easy at the moment. And of course, there's his ex-wife's maintenance that has to be paid.
Oh.
He says to me, well, Crystal should stop doing her handstands in there. That'd stop it knocking. And I have to admit, he's right. She's that lively, honestly. Oh, look at her now. Crystal! Get down off Jenny's fence! Crystal! You'll rip your Miss Muppet dress! This is it. You just can't stop her.
You could go and drag her off.
Well, actually, Jenny, I don't believe in tamping girls down. I mean, you can't be doing with sexism. I think it's really important to let girls express themselves.
Mummy!
Oh, Jessica, what's up? I'm talking! Honestly, the minute she's at that nursery, I'll be going back to that hospital reception for a rest.
Mummy!
Here, Jessica, have your cheery chubby. Oh, no, Jessica, don't suck its sticking up thing.
I want it!
Oh, you can't stop her. It's a terrible thing. All the felt bits come off in her mouth.
Oh, very cheery. If it makes a choke, you should take it off her.
Oh, I can't take it off her. You can't take things off them, can you? Not when everyone else has got them. Cheery chubbies, they're all the rage. It won't be fair.
Not even if it's going to make a choke.
Well, this is it. I mean, this morning she sicked up yellow felt bits all over the supermarket floor.
Oh, right. Jessica, don't go in the hall, love. Stay here on the kitchen tiles.
No, well, this is what Tarek says. He thinks girls should be wrapped in cotton wool. It's the same with Shanila, his daughter by his first marriage.
Oh, he's got another daughter.
Oh, yes, and a son. Teenagers, Shanila and Sammy. Well, that was the main thing for Tarek about coming here onto this estate. It's not far from where they live with their mum. I said to him, well, all the kids should be growing up together. It's only right. And that persuaded him. No, he says, Crystal shouldn't be running up and down the stairs till 10 o'clock every evening, banging about the place. She's only 5, she should be in her bed. I don't know why he's worrying. He sleeps through it. I did think Shanila could babysit, but she doesn't somehow seem very keen.
I know some people in the babysitting circle.
Oh? Who?
Julian and Vanessa Percival. They live just down on the main road.
Julian Percival, son of a minor aristocrat, and big in the local league.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.